UPS, which operates one of the largest commercial trucking fleets in the world, says the new tractors will join the company's extensive alternative fuel and advanced technology vehicle fleet. This includes vehicles that are all electric, hybrid electric, hydraulic hybrid, ethanol, compressed natural gas, liquefied natural gas, propane, and renewable natural gas biomethane. The company unveiled its new electric semi-tractor trailer November 16 near its design center in Hawthorne, California. Tesla CEO Elon Musk said the electric semi is capable of traveling 500 miles on a single electric charge, even with a full 80,000-pound load. He said it will cost less than a diesel semi considering fuel savings, lower maintenance and other factors. "We're confident that this is a product that's better in every way from a feature standpoint," Musk told a crowd of Tesla fans at the unveiling. Four independent motors on each Tesla semi provide maximum power and acceleration with the lowest energy cost, Musk claims. The truck will have Tesla's autopilot system, which can maintain a set speed and slow down automatically in traffic. It has a system that keeps the vehicle in its lane automatically. Musk said several self-driving Tesla semis will be able to travel in a convoy. Musk said Tesla plans to establish a global network of solar-powered megachargers that could give the trucks 400 miles of range after charging for just half an hour. Although he did not mention a price, Musk said customers can put down a $5,000 deposit to reserve the semis now and production will begin in 2019. Tesla does say, electric energy costs are half those of diesel. With fewer systems to maintain, the Tesla semi provides $200,000 plus in fuel savings and a 2-year payback period. J.B. Hunt Transport Services Incorporated and Wal-Mart Stores Incorporated, which operate thousands of trucks, say that they, have reserved Tesla's electric semi-trucks. "Reserving Tesla trucks marks an important step in our efforts to implement industry-changing technology," said John Roberts, President and Chief Executive Officer at J.B. Hunt. "We believe electric trucks will be most beneficial on local and dray routes, and we look forward to utilizing this new, sustainable technology." Truck leasing and fleet management company Ryder System Incorporated is in the process of placing its initial order for a fleet of Tesla semi-trucks. Dennis Cook, the company's president of Global Fleet Management Solutions, told the Wall Street Journal. Ryder did not specify the size of its order. UPS will be among the first companies to put the electric heavy-haul vehicles on the road. For more than a century, UPS has led the industry in testing and implementing new technologies for more efficient fleet operations. "We look forward to expanding further our commitment to fleet excellence with Tesla," said Juan Perez, UPS Chief Information and Engineering Officer. "These groundbreaking electric tractors are poised to usher in a new era in improved safety, reduced environmental impact, and reduced cost of ownership," said Perez. UPS has provided Tesla real-world UPS trucking lane information as part of the company's evaluation of the vehicle's expected performance for the UPS duty cycle. UPS often partners with suppliers of emerging vehicle technologies to help them develop solutions that prove ready for stringent UPS use cases. Musk says Tesla's semi offers an unparalleled cabin experience for drivers, enhanced on-road safety and reduced long-term cost of ownership. Safety features include automatic emergency braking, adaptive cruise control, automated lane guidance, and brake-by-wire and steer-by-wire with redundancy. Tesla's driver assistance features have been found by the U.S. government to reduce crash rates by 40%. UPS's pre-order of Tesla vehicles complements and advances the company's overall commitment to reduce its absolute greenhouse gas emissions from global ground operations 12% by 2025, a goal developed using a methodology approved by the Science Based Targets Initiative. UPS has established a goal for 25% of the electricity it consumes to come from renewable energy sources by 2025. In addition, by 2020 UPS plans that 1 in 4 new vehicles purchased annually will be an alternative fuel or advanced technology vehicle, up from 16% in 2016. The company also set a new goal that by 2025, 40% of all ground fuel will be from sources other than conventional gasoline and diesel, an increase from 19.6% in 2016. UPS says it operates one of the world's safest commercial fleets, and has invested more than $194 million in global health and safety training in 2016. The Tesla Semi offers something to the trucking industry that could drastically alter the entire freight moving sector. The trucking industry has seen major changes since it began roughly a century ago and has, despite the assumptions of many outsiders looking in, been one of the more technologically advanced industries in our nation. Trucks themselves have seen huge changes in the past few decades, while the freight industry as a whole has been reinvented and revamped multiple times over in that same time period. NASDAQ.com contributor Martin Tillier mentions the impacts that the Tesla Semi and others with similar game-changing technologies will have on the trucking industry long-term. Most notably with autonomous trucks and their electric powertrains. The technological change that benefits trucking and delivery businesses has been widely reported, but in my experience most people that I ask about it focus on the potential negatives rather than looking for opportunities, writes Tillier. They ignore the biggest beneficiary of all, trucking companies. They are looking at a future where two of their major costs, fuel and drivers, will be dramatically lower. Those salient points are much bigger picture than most commenting on the Tesla Semi and other related vehicles would note. Just about every major manufacturer of commercial vehicles, including Class 8 trucks, is getting in on the electrification game, and many are also building towards automation. The companies most often noted, like Tesla and Nikola, are actually side players compared to the already established heavy-duty builders like Paccar, Daimler, Volvo, and the like. Even manufacturers like Cummins are working with alternatives to petroleum-burning drivetrains. The stakes are huge. According to the American Trucking Associations, over 70% of the freight moved in the United States is moved by truck. There are about 10.5 billion tons of freight moved around the U.S. annually and about 3.6 million Class 8 trucks on the road pulling that freight. The electrification of trucks is a big step. It won't happen really quickly, but it will happen eventually. How, exactly, that electrification comes will depend on a lot of things. It could be the battery-powered Tesla Semi, or it could be the hydrogen fuel cell-run Toyota Kenworth collaboration. Or any mixture of things, including the range-extending turbine proposed for the original Nikola design or that of Capstone. Whatever the solution or solutions are, freight hauling trucks of all sizes are going to become electric. That's a given. Why? For the same reason they all went to diesel a few decades ago. It's more efficient and thus cheaper. Before diesel, most trucks were powered by gasoline and were extremely inefficient, hauling less weight and getting worse fuel economy. Diesel itself saw many changes over time as the engines it powered improved and emissions fell. Currently, trucks use around 38 billion gallons of diesel fuel a year. At $4 a gallon, that's about $152 billion in fuel. With electricity, costs could be a fraction of diesel. Roughly a quarter of the cost, in fact, in worst-case assumptions. More optimistic numbers would put it in the January 16th to January 8th fractions. The gains with autonomous self-driving or driving assist technology are even higher. In trucking, the highest cost to the trucking company is the driver behind the wheel, with wages and benefits not to mention legalities and downtime having the highest impact on the bottom line. A truck driver can legally drive for 11 hours per day and most drivers average about 600 miles daily. An autonomous truck could drive 24/7, stopping only to load, unload or refuel. Self-driving trucks would also solve a problem that's long plagued the trucking industry, driver shortages. Truck drivers will lose jobs, yes. Eventually. Remember, we're talking decades here, not years. When automated big trucks take over as the bulk of the industry's means of moving freight, most drivers will be required to find new careers. We must remember, however, that truck driving is essentially made up of a labor force which has little formal training and mostly on-the-job experience as their primary resume point. These drivers become more skilled with time and hence demand higher wages. The most skilled workers in truck driving tend also be those closest to retirement. Replacements for those skilled drivers are new drivers who've completed perhaps 3 weeks of trucking school and a month of over-the-road training with a slightly more skilled driver as a mentor. This doesn't make trucking an easy job, but it does mean that those with the most skills are the least likely to lose their jobs when automation becomes the norm. We can argue until our fingers bleed, typing about the feasibility of the Tesla Semi and Elon Musk's promises for the truck's capabilities. Whether Tesla delivers on those promises is moot. As we know that someone, somewhere, and sometime very soon will deliver on similar promises regardless. The trucking industry is going through another sea change. Those in technology, used to a new iPhone every year and to hashtag about cryptocurrencies, might consider a decade or two as a long time to wait. Those in manufacturing and transportation, however, see 20 years as a single generation and their version of 2.0 has huge economic impacts on the nation's and world's economies. The trucking industry knows that electrification and automation are coming. Fast. The Tesla Semi may or may not physically bring that revolution, but it certainly does symbolize it.